Hey guys, so this has been a very requested video since the song was released last Friday. It's my first remix I've released in years, and it's an official remix for Zedd and Katy Perry's new song 365. And this is how that sounds. By the way, the winner of the VST plugin giveaway from last week is this comment, and the mastering is this comment. So congrats to you guys, and this week I'll also be doing the same thing, giving away a synth of your choice to one of the first 100 who sign up to my new mailing list, which you can find down below. One of the first 100 who sign up will win a VST, and I'll also be doing a free mastering to one of the other who sign up. So you'll also be getting some exclusive sample welcome gifts when you sign up, and it's gonna be awesome with like free tickets and arranging meetups, exclusive songs and videos, so be sure to sign up. I would love to get in touch with you guys. And I will, as always, be choosing one of the first 300 commenters on this video to give a free mastering of a song to. But I'll shut up now and let's dive into it. So I got the stems from a manager who got it from Zedd's team. It was on spec, which means that I basically could give it a go, but it was not sure, and it was just if they liked the remix, they would release it, potentially. This was one day before I was headed to Barcelona with Tiësto, and then we were going to Amsterdam to work on music for a week. And the deadline was in 1 week, so I pretty much had one day to get most of the work done, and then after like no sleep whatsoever during the first couple of days at the camp, I got it done luckily, and Zedd loved it. He started playing it out at his shows, which was amazing, a dream come true. But I'm gonna shut up now for the second time and let's dive into how it was made. So the most important thing here was that it's in like 90-98 BPM, I think. It's very slow, and to push that up to 126 or 124, I think I ended up with, I really had to do something else with, especially the chords, because the mood of the song was really, it was really something special. The chords are really weird, but they have this like weird feeling, and I wanted to project more energy into the song. For instance, the most important part here is where the original chords, they go like, you'll make a week and feel like a year, baby, you got me changing 24/7. I want you here, I hope you feel the same thing. I want you to be the one that's on my, into the chorus on the pre-chorus, which is a really important part. But I wanted, they sound amazing, the chords, they're super beautiful, but I felt it needed to have some more energy in it, because it was gonna be like a banger, a house banger remix. So I ended up with something like this. You'll make a week and feel like a year, baby, you got me changing 24/7. I want you here, I hope you feel the same thing. I want you to be the one that's on my mind, on my mind, on my mind. I want you to be there on a Monday. So yeah, you get the idea. I felt that gave it more energy, and it just really built up to the chorus in a more house-friendly way, at least. When I had that down, I felt like, that took me a long time to figure out, but when I had it, I felt like, okay, this is good, could potentially work, because I was a bit unsure if I was going to be able to make it. So when I had those chords down, I felt like I had some foundation. So I started with, waking up next to you in the middle of the week, never needed anyone to send me off to sleep, and I know I said go slow, but I can't hold back no more, which in essence is, it's actually funny because the ARP, I tried to recreate the ARP that was in the original, because I wanted sort of to recreate it sort of similar, so it sounds like a remix, but it sounds a bit different. I ended up with just using the pluck that I made in the 1 hour track challenge. So that was a bit funny, because I really ended up liking that pluck. So you can check that out if you want to make the same one. I felt it fit the track, and I had this pad from Substance, the Signal plugin. Just this fat pad thing. And yeah, as I said, this was all made in like very little time, because I had to leave. So it's pretty much just a very rough idea, and I'll go over what I added later, but this is the foundation. I added these just pitch up of the vocal with some reverb just to make it stand out from the remix, no, the original a bit more. And so I added these clock thing sound because I know Zed likes clocks, and that sounded wrong. But this was recorded at a camp this autumn, I think, and it was like a really dark room, and we had this creepy clock tick on the wall, and we sampled it, and that's how it sounded. So I actually ended up using that. It's a bit funny, and it just goes on in the background, just keeping the tension. And yeah, I thought Zed would like it. That's pretty much the reason why I have it there. Another important thing here is the tempo switch, because originally this was in 118 BPM, and then it went up to 125 in the build-up, but I ended up scrapping that idea, and the final result is just a static one in 124, because people told me it didn't make sense to like do a tempo switch from 118 to 126 because it was so little, and they were right. It sounded so much better in just keeping it on 124. So that's that. In the pre-chorus, we have these sounds. You make a week and feel like a year, baby, you got me changing 24/7. Which is, you make a week and feel like a year. These strings. The play the chords. We have the, they're from, the strings are from Kontakt, just the Session Strings Pro. The pad is from Trillian. I love Trillian. It's just a pad I usually use a lot, and I have this airy piano thing from Signal, which has a little bit of a rhythm to it just to give it a bit of drive. This one, same one as from the verse. I have this kick coming in the pre-chorus. You make a week and feel like a year, baby, you got me changing 24/7. I want, supposed to have an automation on it. Yeah. You make a week and feel like a year, baby, you got. It's just a kick from an upcoming single of mine actually that I sampled, which I'm going to be giving away very soon. And as always, all the samples can be found in the description of the remix. Get into this part. 24/7, I want you here. I hope you feel the same thing. Kick speed up into the chorus. What also comes in here are these, you make a weekend, claps at the pre-chorus. You make a weekend feel like a year, baby, you got me changing 24/7. Just to get some groove in there. And you make a weekend feel like a year. Oh, I also have a vocoder on the vocal. You make a week and feel like a year, baby, you got. Which is this vocal synth. You make a week and feel like a year, baby, you. Just following the chords. I think I actually scrapped this in the end because it was too messy, or I lowered it a lot in volume, I think. You make a week. You make a week and feel like. Anyways, we get into the chorus here. The clock continues into here. We also get these cowbells. I love cowbells. Just sounds so nice and just has a long reverb on it. It pitches up, I think. Yeah. Just to, oh shit, what's happening with the sound? Just to add some movement to it, build some tension when it pitches up, then pitches down again. I thought, yeah, into the build. So that's, sounds like this. Yeah, you can't really hear it. We also have this extra layer of really high claps that just adds some grit to it. We also have the pads. They sound like, this is from the analog brass and winds. Just to give it some like epic, triumphant feeling, because the chords are really epic there when it builds up. No, I mean in the chorus, they're really epic with everything. And this, more subby layer. And this is a nice trick, because here you have the, I'll show you in the MIDI, you have the rhythms trying to come in. It's very subtle, but with the vocal, it accentuates those hits. I'll show you with the extra layer here, which is this one. I want you to be the one that's on my mind, on my mind, on my mind. Okay, so I'll lower this a bit in volume so you can hear what I'm doing. I want you to be the one that's on my mind, on my mind, on my mind. You get that bum 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 bum. Really accentuate that, because you want to get that groove in before the build and the drop comes, because that's the groove of the drop. Because I kept the, I want you to be the one that's on this rhythm and the vocal really in the drop. I want you to be the one that's on my mind, on my mind, on my mind. I want you to be there on a Monday night, Tuesday. And I wanted the bass line to move, but not the sub to be gone when it goes up there, so which is why I ended up using two layers here. It's super distorted. So you go in to the next sound, which is this very basic pluck, I think. Very simple, like short sound. And then I put this on, which was pure luck. I just browsed through the presets and this is how that sounds, which was really cool, I think, and added to some atmosphere and just, yeah. The notes are like building up instead of going down there, so adds some harmonics. And to really push the chords we have, and the rhythm as well, is this. Again, just from init, very basic plucks, but they work. Yeah, and they're also automated with the cutoff to make them move. But to get that punch in the chorus, I really want, you sort of needed that like 16th or 8th groove. Just, yeah, 16th. To get some more energy into it, because I was struggling a bit with that. Now, I've had a lot of comments about this, which is, which is this. The shittiest electric guitar in the world. Yeah, it's not here right now, but it's horrible. And I can't play, so I had to like chop it up really, really accurately. Like every single note is cut up, because I just can't play. I had to like figure all the, I can't play at all. But you can make it work if you have enough time, which I didn't. But it worked. I put this retro RC20 on it to create some movement with the wobble function. I love it. Some CQ to pop the highs, and then the guitar rig. I just browsed through the presets. There are so many presets, so you can just do whatever and you'll find something cool. So feel free to copy these settings, but yeah, as I said, you can just browse through the presets and you'll find something good. So when we had that foundation, I felt we just needed to add stuff to make it bigger, and I just dragged in a lot of shit from my sample packs, which you can download on the link below. These are the strings from my song Breathe, and I didn't even do anything on them. I just put them in, slapped them in, pitched them up, and that's it. They work so well, and that's a trick I often use, is just putting in these epic strings. Even if you can't really hear them, they really add that epic feel. Another run sample from Breathe, just a downlifter impact thing. One from Blackbird with ELS. Another one. Oops. Another one from Blackbird. Just, yeah. When I'm in a rush and I just like to slap in the samples and just, it's just so fast to get stuff done. I have this. I don't even know where this is from. It was just some random horn sounding sample. I have this going as well, which is just some drum fill from the plugin Arcade, which cutoff filter is gradually moving up. It's panning around and just adds some more energy when it's like these fast rhythm. So that's pretty much that for the chorus. So now it sounds like this. Oh, I didn't even process the vocal in this project. I probably did that later then. So into the build, I kept the clock. I love the clock. Kept the claps. The cowbell is pitching up, and this thing is staying on that last note. I've spoken about doing that in other videos. It's a trick I often use to keep that tension in the build, just staying on that last chord. You really want it to release, if that makes sense. I keep the electric shit guitar. just panning around to keep that sound and just some tension. Keep the strings. Another downlifter, the horns. And I add the some claps here. So another thing I like to do is keep the rhythm on the four, like, but introduce some element on the two in the build-up, because then you really get into the groove more easily. I have some snares, I think I replaced them. Just regular snares pitching up. And I have this brass thing, just keeping some tension there. This is funny, I actually kept the original chords from the pre-chorus, which is in the build-up, because I felt like they really brought it back home, and they were sounded epic as F. Yeah, for the juicy part, we have the vocal choppy thing. That is introducing, and we end up with this before the drop. Give me the night. Where I have a couple of effects here doing this thing, which is one is the tape stop at the end. Give me the night. Just stops it. And give me the night. This is just manipulator is just making it go from light to dark. Give me the night. Give me the night. And I automate that so it gradually gets darker and more robotic. Give me the night. Yeah, this isn't doing much, but it adds some layer of the root note, the D. Oops. Give me the night. Towards the end. So that's pretty much it for the break. I hate to leave you guys on a cliffhanger like this, but I have so much I have to do, and it's taking me so long to film the entire thing, and I'm already late with the upload. It should be uploaded today. So I'm gonna have to leave it here for today, and next week I'll jump into the drop and finalize that and show you guys how that was made. I'm really sorry. I know you hate this, but it's the only way I can make it work right now, because I have so many deadlines before Ultra on Friday and Saturday. I'm not going, but be sure to check the live stream, because a lot of new music will be played by awesome artists there. So I'm super excited for everything that's happening, and thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to sign up on the thing below, and I'll talk to you guys next week. Thank you for understanding.